This week, we're wrapping up Obscure Characters Month with a look at the short history of one of the earliest bots who could possibly qualify for the title, HAULER. HAULER was an Autobot truck crane who appeared in the very first episode of the Transformers animated series in 1984. Featured in only one scene, helping to hoist the damaged Hound up from the bottom of a cliff, HAULER never spoke, never transformed, and was never seen in the series again. He would be an enigma to fans for many years. He wasn't part of the Transformers toy line, but he was clearly based on a toy, specifically the truck crane figure that had been released early in 1984 as part of the Japanese toy line, Diaclone. We still don't know the full story, but it's generally assumed by fans that Hasbro must have planned to import the figure and release it as part of the first year of the Transformers toy line as HAULER, only for its release to be cancelled at the last minute, too late to remove HAULER from the first episode. Supporting this theory is the fact that the 1984 assortment of Autobot cars were distributed to toy stores in boxes of 12. But there were only 11 figures in the range, with a second Mirage figure being included in each box to make up the numbers, suggesting that HAULER might have been intended to be the 12th figure. Whatever the story behind its absence, the truck crane figure would eventually be released as part of the Transformers line in 1985, reimagined as a new character named Grapple. For nearly 20 years, HAULER seemed destined to be remembered only as an obscure oddity from the early days of the franchise. International dubs of the cartoon removed his name, and an action card released in 1985 depicting his one scene even relabeled him as Grapple. But then, in the year 2003, HAULER suddenly hit the big time when a toy of him was released through Japanese online retailer eHobby. Sold under the name Road HAULER, the toy was naturally a recolor of the Grapple truck crane figure, but with a new green and purple color scheme based on the Decepticon combiner team, the Constructicons. The profile included with the toy gave HAULER a personality and a backstory for the first time, revealing that he used to be a member of the Constructicons back on Cybertron before his teammates were reprogrammed for evil by Megatron, as seen in the cartoon episode The Secret of Omega Supreme. HAULER managed to escape being reprogrammed and went on to join the Autobots. Soon after arriving on Earth, he took to traveling the world full-time, locating and securing energy resources for his new comrades, a justification for his disappearance from the cartoon after the first episode. He was characterized as a fickle bot, prone to sudden changes in mood and behavior, which he expressed by frequently changing his color scheme, explaining why the toy's colors didn't match the cartoon. The decision to make HAULER a former Constructicon was seemingly influenced by the subpar animation of the cartoon episode Five Faces of Darkness Part 4, which in a series of flashbacks to the era before the war, included a shot of a Constructicon-colored version of Grapple's vehicle mode, and a scene of the Constructicons that featured 8 members instead of the regular 6, making HAULER one of these 2 additional bots. Now, to digress for a little bit, since this is a short episode and it's a good opportunity to throw him in, if you were wondering, yes, an identity would later be created for the 8th and final Constructicon as well. 2012's Transformers United EX toy line would name this mystery bot Gravedigger. Gravedigger was a preliminary name for the Constructicon leader Scrapper, which first became known to fans when it was used by mistake for one line of the 1985 adventure gamebook Dinobots Strike Back. Compounding the error, artist William Schmidt drew Constructicon dump truck Long Haul instead of Scrapper in the illustration for the scene, which inspired fans to have a bit of fun and think of Gravedigger as being his own distinct character instead of just a mistake. This idea was made official by United EX, which included a toy of Gravedigger, sold under the name Buildmaster, and explained that he was the younger brother of the team's demolitions expert Bonecrusher, who was often left out of the group's activities due to an unstable temper that made him unsuited to construction work. Anyway, getting back to Hauler. In the years since E-Hobby turned him into a distinct character with a real place in the Transformers universe, he's enjoyed a handful of intermittent cameo appearances in both Japanese manga and media from the Transformers Collectors Club. There have been new grapple toys, but so far, sadly, none of them have been recolored to create any new versions of Hauler. Most recently, Hauler's status as a character from the first season of the original cartoon, however minor, led to him being included on the 2019 ballot for the Transformers Hall of Fame, though it shouldn't come as much of a surprise that he didn't win. But Hauler's got his own special brand of fame that nobody can take away from him. He'll always be remembered as one of the first obscure characters in Transformers history. And those are the basics on Hauler and Gravedigger 2 for good measure. I hope you've enjoyed this year's Obscure Characters Month. If so, maybe give the like button a click or subscribe for more Transformers lore. It's back to the big subjects next month, and you can support the series on Patreon to get early access to those new episodes.